Good evening, everyone. I want to welcome you to another exciting series of Central Communities TV. Today, we're going to learn an exciting dance that we call Chicago Style Stepping. We're going to go into a couple of exercises, then we're going to go into a couple of maneuvers, and we're going to have a lot of fun today. We're going to learn this dance. And today, we're going to learn about Chicago Style Stepping. So don't go anywhere.
That's what I'm talking about.
Thank you.
Okay, for Denise.
Okay. That's
one, two,
three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay? Mm-hmm. All right.
Thank you. Everyone, the color of my world.
who did not, was not able to come tonight. We got another class tomorrow night. So you get two classes in one night. And yes. I didn't come out tomorrow night as well. Okay. So what do you think about class tonight? Okay. And I want to get some, because I already know I don't want to sit up and talk, I want to get some interaction from you all, because it's not just a one-man show. I want to hear something from you all, what you all gain tonight. And then, like, or this is the first night, and what I want you to do is tell us a little something that you learned tonight.
I learned to act.
Okay.
I like, and the beat. I'm learning the beat. I didn't know it was a beat to step in music. I just thought it didn't go with the flow, but it's a beat to it, and I like the beat. And I'm learning to count with the beat and along with the step. It's something totally different to me, and I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying it.
Good. Good. Well, I know I struggle with terms. You know, even though you're putting it into the terms, I still do a lot with it, because that's one of my weak points is terms. You know, so when you say, oh, you know, something about turning.
Yeah, but that's okay. But that's okay. It's going to take practice. And one thing about the turn is that I learned that when I'm doing female turns, I don't have to quit, so I can't make a mistake with you guys. You know, but I can do the turn. And one thing that I do know is that if you put your foot behind, you're going to have a difficult time turning. Okay? Because in this particular dance, and I teach the placement of your feet because it's very important, your feet. And for instance, when you're doing your basic, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, the placement of your foot, of your feet, is going to be the same as when you turn. Okay? Watch. This is the basic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, 1, 2, 3, you know where 3 is, you know where 4 is, okay? And if I did a half left, my 3 and my 4 is going to be in the same position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. I'm going to do it back here. My 4 is 4. My 4 is already in place to go back home. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? And when you start doing turns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you just practice on your basic, the placement of your feet, it's going to help you on your turns as well. Anybody got any input for that?
What I just learned, I feel like the more classes that you take, the better you get, and you become a lot more comfortable just watching some of the styles of the ladies. We were just discussing how they are able to make their feet do certain things, but it's just developing your own style.
Right.
You know,
right.
Right.
The basic is the basic.
Yes.
Everybody does their dance different, but the basic is the same. And then once you get grounded in your basic, you can put your own flavor, swagger, whatever you want to call it, and get your own identity. But until you get grounded in your basics, you're not going to be able to do any of that, because folks have been doing this for quite a long time. And guess what? They've been practicing a long time. And practice make perfect.
You know, that's what I found to be the key. While I've been stepping for years, there's always something you can learn. You know, I don't care how long a person's been stepping. You can see other people who come from out of town and they may do something different. So to me, it's always a evolving dance. And the other thing is too, once you are really grounded in your basics and you're confident and you being back to where your partner needs for you to be, you know, you can create some of your own things that you may pull from other dances as well. But the dance itself, I think, is the most elegant and sophisticated dance I've ever done.
I agree. And one key thing is get your own identity, because you can mimic somebody else, but get your own identity. Get the basics. Get grounded in the basics, and then, you know, all this other swag, you know, this is a better than dance. Yes, ma'am.
I'm sorry. For me, it's just learning how to keep my count and knowing how to count. And you know, no matter how long people are steppers, you've got to keep the count.
Exactly. No matter
how grounded you are, if they don't keep that count, then you're off.
Yes.
Counting. You got to have
the count.
Yeah. But I'll tell you, I've learned a lot today. Just from looking at the different people, I mean, some of it I might be able to use, others I may not. But the one thing that I can absolutely take away from tonight's class is to stay totally in my lane and pretend I have a little square and make all my words. And if I, a vision having a mirror, if I can't see myself in that mirror, I've gone too far.
Anybody else?
Yeah, I'll just say something. I have danced in the past. I've done jazz and ballet, but stepping is totally different. It's a beautiful dance, and it's a lot of fun, but it is a dance with its own skill set and technique to it. So it's important to know that even though you may be from a background of different dances, it's a wonderful new way of dancing.
The one thing is you have to be grounded in your basics with stepping. Mm-hmm. You can't fake it.
And the thing is, and I totally agree, you got different styles, different dances, and those individuals who learn and master those dances, they didn't do it overnight. They took practice. Practice, practice, practice. And that's the only way you're going to get better. You come to class, but if you don't go to different events and come to class, continue to practice. This dance you can get as good as you want to get. It's all left up to you. Okay? And how long does someone master this dance? I don't think anyone masters the dance. They mastered some techniques in this particular dance, but there's always room for learning. And the only way you're going to learn is continue to practice.
One thing that I do like about the Chicago dance itself is that it's national. It's not just here in Central Florida. When I travel, one of the things I do is I always go on the internet. I look for other classes, other events. And one thing about the Chicago dance is that it's a very embracing community. No matter where you go, you're never going to be a stranger. People will welcome you. Since you travel with it, you can meet new people. It's a wonderful opportunity to network.
Now, and that's very true. I travel a lot. And every city I go to, I find a stepping group. And it's like a family. It really is. That's very true.
And just to let you all know, we have some visitors. We have some visitors from Boston.
From Boston?
I've been sending an email to whoever, you know, is stepping in that area and find out where they're having their practice, and I attend their practice, and if we get to go out and party, this is my second time about that.
I was one of the people she met.
Yes, and I learned the steps you taught me, the technique, and I took it home, and I taught you. That's how it is. Everybody's like, oh, look at that. And I have met all of them. Them classes over.
Yeah.
When we partied.
Yeah, we did.
And I was so surprised because when we went to the BFW hall, they had, it was other people there that knew how to step. And it was like, oh, wow. I'm not used to that. We're trying to get to that point where we have, you know, when we go out to different venues, there are other people there other than just us who know how to step. But, it's beautiful. I mean, since I was here, I've been to Atlanta to the Heritage Ball, took classes there, and had a great time and danced. I mean, danced, and I didn't know I was up so late. and the people were still there dancing when I left. They didn't hear me. I was like, oh my God.
Oh, yeah.
Called Chicago Steppers into the family.
Went to Baltimore, took classes there, met people there.
Any place I've been to, Virginia Beach, extended.
So Linda, and just like I was found by some other folks, thanks to the wonderful Nicole. They went on Google and they found Forest Steppers International. Linda, the same thing. So I am pleased to know that what we're doing is that we're getting out there. Folks, you know that there is stepping going on in the state of Florida. Okay. And so with the creation of this TV shoot tonight, and along with the shooting of the second annual All Black Stepping Extravaganza, Florida's going to be on the map. So with that, class tomorrow night, and for those who have not purchased their ticket for the All White Step Extravaganza, because I'm such a nice guy, I kept the ticket price at the early bird special, especially for you all. And if you haven't gotten the tickets yet, I still have some early bird tickets left because I want to make sure that everybody gets tickets. Okay. Any questions? Any input? Okay, with that, we want to gather around. Does anybody want to send a prayer? And family that prays together, stay together.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment right now. Father, we thank you for this time. We thank you for all who is present in your name. Father, we thank you for bringing us all together to be on one accord with our dance. Father, we just ask and we pray that all of us continue to dance and be on one accord and to gather together in good favor and to cheer each other on and be supportive of each other. Father, we thank you for Walter Lane, who's trying to do a good effort with Florida Steppers International. We thank you for each and everybody that's standing in your name. We ask that you give them traveling grace and mercy. And we also thank you for the group who's come here to televise, and we're just asking God that you let your will be done, that not only will you make Walter Lane's group one of the most prominent ones, that all of the groups that participate in Fort Stepping, Chicago Stepping, we ask this in your name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. I love them. Jesus.